myself, Darshan Kumar, Deputy Curator on behalf of National Gallery of Modern Art Bengaluru, a subordinate office of Ministry of Culture, Government of India. Welcome you all to the inaugural ceremony of the INAU's curated exhibition
titled Prabuddha Dasgupta, A Journey. I would now call up the director, Ms. Nazneen Banu, to give the welcome address. And with the distinguished guests, we also have with us Mr. Prabuddha Dasgupta's family with us.
Well, namaskar and a very good evening to all of you. Chief guest of the evening, Mrs. Pushpamala, Mr. Umesh Ganjam, other distinguished invitees, my dear friends, ladies and gentlemen. As Director, National Gallery of Modern Art, Bengaluru, which is a subordinate office of Ministry of Culture, Government of India, it gives me immense pleasure to welcome you all this evening to our latest presentation, which is the inaugural function of Prabuddha Dasgupta, A Journey, an in-house curated exhibition of NGMA Bengaluru. It's a retrospective exhibition of a very renowned, noted, and iconic Indian photographer, late Shri Prabuddha Dasgupta, who revolutionized the concept of fashion photography in India and also carved a niche for Indian photographers in international arena. He was not a formally trained photographer, and probably that's the reason why his works are so unique and bear no resemblance to the conventional photography. This exhibition consists of about 90 images spanning across three decades of photographic journey, starting from early 80s to till about 2011. All the works on display form part of permanent collection of NGMA and includes some of his personal works from the series Women, Ladakh, Edge of Faith, and Longing. Longing, which is the last series on which he was working before his untimely demise in the year 2012. Besides this, other commissioned works from series Ganjam, Hampi, and commercial works of brand like Louis Vuitton, Vogue are also part of this exhibition. The present photographic exhibition is entirely different from our previous presentation titled Itihas, which showcased about 150 sculptures of eminent artists such as D.P. Roy Chaudhary, Ram Kinkar Baij, Shanko Chaudhary, Dhanraj Bhagat, and Sharbari Roy Chaudhary, who were pioneers of modernist sculpture in India. Incidentally, few works of late sculptor Shri Pradosh Dasgupta, who was father of Prabuddha Dasgupta, were also part of our previous exhibition, Itihas. This exhibition is an attempt to unlock our own treasures and add variety to our display. We also plan to host and curate many outreach programs around this exhibition over a period of about next 2 months to make it more meaningful, more educative, and benefiting a wider audience. Catalog of this exhibition would also be available for sale at the museum shop for the benefit of our visitors. Well, I would like to conclude by quoting a few lines of late Shri Prabuddha Dasgupta, which he spoke at Delhi Photo Festival in 2011. And he said, and I quote, that I want to have a long string of images held together by grace, because grace is that indefinable, non-rational, non-linear word that I'm looking for, unquote. And ladies and gentlemen, I'm sure after a preview of this show, which you would witness in a short while from now, you will agree with me that what he left for us is indeed a long string of images held together by grace and which evokes a certain sense of longing. With this, I would also like to take this opportunity to express my sincere thanks to the Director General of National Gallery of Modern Art and Ministry of Culture, Government of India, for their continued support and guidance. Thanks to the curatorial team and staff of National Gallery of Modern Art, Bengaluru, for their dedication and commitment to work, which has made this exhibition a reality. Special thanks to the estate of PRABUDDHA DASGUPTA for their cooperation and support extended during mounting of this exhibition at NGMA. Thank you one and all for sparing your valuable time and for being part of this inauguration. Thank you very much. Jai Hind.
I would like to call artist Pushpamala for giving a few words, to say a few words about her. Everybody knows her. She doesn't need an introduction in Bangalore. But anyways, we are proud to have her here for the for inaugurating the exhibition. She has been the most entertaining artist, iconoclast of contemporary Indian art. In her sharp and witty works as a photo and a video performance artist, sculptor, writer, curator, and a provocateur, and in her collaboration with writers, theatre directors, and filmmakers, she seeks to subvert the dominant cultural and intellectual discourse. She is known for her strong feminist work and her rejection of authenticity and embracing of multiple realities. As one of the pioneers of conceptual art in India and a leading figure in the feminist experiments in subject, material, and language, her inventive work in sculpture, conceptual photography, video, and performance have had a deep influence in art practice in India. Ma'am, I would request you to kindly come and say a few words as you have met Mr. PRABUDDHA DASGUPTA in your, you know, in the past. So I request you to come and share your experience.
Thank you for inviting me. It's a pleasure to be here. Actually, PRABUDDHA, I don't know if many people know, but PRABUDDHA DASGUPTA lived for several years in Bangalore. In fact, I met him in Balan Nambiar's place, I think, for the first time for lunch. And after that, I met him a few times when we were printing in Delhi. And that was also interesting because he started off as a darkroom photographer, analog photographer. And I remember having this conversation with him in Delhi while we were waiting to, you know, we are supervising our prints. I said, how do you find it, you know, switching from analog photography to digital photography? So he says, yeah, I'm getting used to it. In fact, all these over here are digital prints. So he said, now I'm learning to work with Photoshop. And Photoshop, by the way, unlike what most people think, is like a dark room. It's just on the computer. Sometimes it's also called Lightroom. So it's a way of working on your photographs. So he was very particular about the technical and aesthetic aspects of his work. And what's interesting is this whole art background, though basically he's known as a commercial photographer and advertising, basically working for advertising and fashion. He was a son of a very well-known modernist sculptor, Pradosh Dasgupta, and as he states himself, grew up with artists. And you can find that sort of influence on his work. I mean, even his sort of obsession with the female nude. It's a very, very modernist genre. And I remember when I first encountered his work, it was on the streets of Bangalore when he was doing his very famous campaign for Ganjam jewelers. So I think those posters were put up, those you know, on all the poles, if I'm not mistaken. They said, what is this fantastic, you know, photography? And I think he did several things with that whole campaign because he just changed the kind of aesthetic of Indian, you know, fashion and advertising photography. For one thing, those images were in black and white, which is unusual for advertising photography or fashion photography. And they had this very strong contrasty tones, like the very deep blacks and whites. And again, another absolutely revolutionary thing is he used very dark skin models, which, you know, how obsessed Indians are with fair skin, and you'll hardly find you know, any models who are really dark skinned. And I think he first started with Lakshmi, his partner, and then he also used some male models, equally very dark skinned South Indian models. And there are some very interesting things about his advertising at this particular Ganjam campaign. Some of them are over here, actually, but what I've seen is the earlier ones, probably, which had actual bodies. You know, even now, if you see jewelry advertisements, it's very fussy and it's very ostentatious. You'll find a kind of flat sort of, you know, lighting used, a lot of color, and you'll find Aishwarya Rai or one of these stars, like, you know, loaded with jewelry from top to bottom. And it's very gaudy, basically. But if you see Prabuddha's work, it's very minimal. Sometimes it's just a part of a body, or even a kind of a plant or a tree or the sand or sometimes a crab or a seashell or something like that, which is holding a ring or a necklace or something. I'm sure Mr. Ganja must have known him, and he might speak a bit more about that. So it's very interesting, sort of a very minimal, you know, aesthetic, which again he takes from modernism, like modern art. So this very interesting, this whole, I think that's what makes him different and a kind of a trendsetter in particularly fashion and, advertising photography, though of course he has also done portraits, and I hadn't seen any of his landscapes. They're also very nice, actually, and I like those ones of Ladakh and Hampi. And I don't think anyone's really used that, though Bharat Sekka and some of the younger people have studied with, I mean, have worked with him. I don't think they've actually used that aesthetic in the way that he has. It's very nice to see the show over here, and congratulations to the NGMA for bringing it up. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. I would also take the liberty to say Ms. Pushpamala is one of the inspiring and favorite artists among the young artists in Bangalore. I am one of them. I now request Mr. Umesh Ganjam, Joint Managing Director Ganjam, the chief guest for today's evening program, to come and share his experience of working with Mr. Prabuddha. Sir.
Respected Director, Srimati Pushpamala, Srimati Tanya Dasgupta, and art-loving friends of Bangalore. I would prefer to read from what I prepared so that I make my points very clear, unlike she's so spontaneous in her, being an artist, she would be spontaneous. I'm extremely happy that the curated work of my friend, Shri Prabuddha Dasgupta, is being exhibited at NGMA, Bangalore. It is my privilege to be a part of this event. I would like to recall a few incidents from my life which highlight the significance of Prabuddha's contribution to the world of art. Once during a visit to Milan in 2003 for an event, I was walking down the city center on a sunny afternoon, and to my surprise, I spotted a very familiar image in the show window. One of Prabuddha's, from a collection titled Ga. Just now she spoke about the collection, the title Ga. Ga is a Kannada word, Ga, Ka Ka Ga. So that was intrigued. I went into inquire. The manager lady took time to explain to me about the publisher. His name was Franco Maria Ricci. He's called FMR. He published an art book, very original art book, handmade, with using Bodoni, you know, typeface. Bodoni typeface is something that is the first church used for printing Bible, and they still continue to do that hand by hand. Each book is published, and that was the kind of book they used to do. And Franco Maria Ricci was an ardent follower of art, and I do not know how he had taken these images and kept in his library in the front, and I saw that. Then I went and spoke to him. He said, "This is something that the world has to see. This is the new emotion, and I'm glad it is coming from India. And I want Milan and the rest of the world to see." So I said, I'm keeping those few images. Then, of course, it's part of history that we had many exhibitions, and all his friends came, and they took him into different parts of Europe. But this was in 2003. And then it's not just that. Wherever these images were, the first thing that people came and saw, for a moment, they would just open their eyes, their mouth, and there was an awe. Complete awe of his images. It would take for some time for them to start even a dialogue. So there was a school in Florence, and the school conducts every 2 years art and research, research in art, and they have a seminar. And for the school and for the entire gallery, when I went, there were two pictures of Prabhudo. And the director in the public meeting like this, for the city meeting, he said, this we want to put for the school and every artist to motivate and to inspire. This is what creativity is. Even today, if you go to Florence, those two images are there right in front of that building. And that's Prabhudo for you, friends. So I think this is, but they had never met Prabhudo. They had not seen him. They had not spoken to him. But his images were all there all the time. And I happened to be in some places where he was there and some places he was not there. So in one of the, it used to be like this. For those work of Prabhudo, we would meet in a farm, in his farm, his land. Tanya is here, it would go on before he would even start. For Hampi, we used to do some work for Karnataka government before with another photographer. He was quite almost two times the age of mine when I was young. And then when he was getting old, one day he sent one mail to me saying, Umesh, my name is Umesh. He said, look, I think you should be working with this person. Henceforth, I am 19 now, so I think you should start working with him. And we were doing photography. We did Hampi then for the Karnataka government, for the government. It was in 88 and then something with Mastabhishekha, etc. So that was Prabhudo's introduction to me as how we are going to work on and photography. Then I have to do photography with this gentleman. So with Prabhudo, it would go on, and finally for Hampi, again we said we'll do Hampi. It took 3 years for us to discuss, and finally you can see some of the images of Hampi. But the important thing that I wanted to say was that even though the Prabhudo did not go to some places, his images would speak. So when we were talking, it reminded me of a Kannada poem, and I recited one evening in a long discussion, and the poem is like this. It is from a well-known poet called D.V. Gundappa, or D.V.G. And this is how it was. Vana sumadali enna jeevanavu vikasisuvante manavan oggaliso guruve he deva. Janake santasaiva gananu nanendemba enike torade jagada pogalikage bai bidade. This is all that I said. Uncannily enough, without knowing the language, he captured the essence of it. I was stunned. And there were no words and there was silence. And the silence continued forever. Thank you, gentlemen. This is all I want to say. Prabhudo.
Thank you, sir. May I now request the distinguished guest, Ms. Pushpamala, Mr. Umesh Ganjam, Ms. Nazneen Banu, and Tanya Das Gupta, Mr. Subarna Patro, curator NGMAB, and our curatorial assistant team, Mr. Lingraj Eshwant, and Shivputra, to please come and light the lamp and declare the exhibition inaugurated.
Good evening, everyone, honorable distinguished guests. It's my privilege to present a vote of thanks on this occasion of inauguration of exhibition of three late Prabhudda Dasgupta, A Journey. It's an in-house curated exhibition by NGMA Bengaluru. On behalf of National Gallery of Modern Art, Bengaluru, Director General NGMA, Shri Aditya Gadnaik, Director NGMA Bengaluru, Srimati Nazneen Banu, and curatorial team, all the staff members of NGMA Bengaluru, I extend my special vote of thanks to our chief guest, Srimati Pushpamala N, eminent photo and visual artist, our guest of honor, Shri Umesh Ganjam, Joint Managing Director Ganjam, for graceful presence with us today. I would like to extend my special thanks to Director NGMA Bengaluru, Srimati Nazneen Banu, for her outstanding support. Also, I would like to thank my curatorial team and all my dear colleagues for their contribution in any form and reach it success today. On behalf of National Gallery of Modern Art, Bengaluru, I extend warm vote of thanks to PRABUDDHA DASGUPTA Estate for cooperating and supporting to execute the exhibition and make the show success. I must mention our deep gratitude to advisory committee members and chairman advisory committee, Sri V. Nagdas, and all advisory committee members, of NGMA Bengaluru for their sincere advice and support. I extend my sincere thanks to Ministry of Culture, Government of India, for continuing supporting and patronage to NGMA Bengaluru. Finally, I would like to thank the audience, artist community, art lover of NGMA for being present here today and made the event a great success. Thank you.
Thank you all. Thank you all for being here with us today. And I request the guests to open the ribbon.
La Pepa Ma, y el Marmalade.